Guys, happy Friday. I hope everyone's having a nice day so far. Remember, we have our Zoom class Zoom meeting today, so make sure I hope I see you guys all there. And we are going to read today our chapter. We'll just probably finish it. So just a couple pages today. Okay. Sorry, both of my neighbors are mowing the lawn, so it might be a little loud. So I'll try to talk a little bit louder. Okay. You listen to me, you stupid mutt. I swear I will rip your ugly... Oh, zip it, Patsy, Tuck said, not even looking at her. His eyes were out the window, watching as the hounds hopped into a pickup truck a few cars behind theirs. I know you don't like it, but you're going to have to deal. You got any better ideas for staying ahead of those guys and not losing your soul in the process? Patsy glared at him, her eyes flashing and her tail whipping furiously. Dogtails can whisper. I didn't think so, Tuck said, so get used to it. It ain't a treat for me either, you know. You ain't exactly a French fry. We got another light coming up, Brody announced. They all stretched to look. See that yellow car coming the other way? Yep. If we jump now and switch directions, it might catch them off guard. We can put some distance between us. Got it. You give the signal. You ready, Patsy? Tuck asked, bending toward her. Her only answer was a growl, but it didn't slash with her claws or run away. Tuck picked her up in his teeth. Now, Brody shouted. They burst through the side of the braking van and landed with stumbling feet on the painted line between the lanes of the road. The yellow car was already right there, speeding in the opposite direction. Without even a chance to get to their feet properly under them, Brody and Tuck sprang into it. That was close, Tuck said, spitting out Patsy in the back seat. Did it work? Kind of. They're still behind us, but now there are a few more cars back, in the red car with the dark windows. Well, at least we've got some time to figure out a plan, Tuck said. How you doing, Patsy? Brody asked. The cat looked up. She'd been angrily licking her back where Tuck had held her. This is the worst night of my life, she said, and I'm not even alive. At least it's working. It looks like you've still got as much soul as you started with. I wish I could stay the same for you guys, she said, looking at their shine. That last hop especially cost you. The faster we're moving, the harder you hit, the more soul you lose. Well, we don't have a lot of choices. Uh-oh, Tuck interrupted. What? Their car. It's moving faster than ours. It's already past two others. Brody joined him at the window. There were only two cars between them and the red one now. It was in the next lane over. As they watched, it pulled past another car. You're sure they're in it? Tuck asked, squinting at the darkened windows of the red car. Yeah, I saw them hop in. This is bad. They were really moving now, the street humming underneath them. Brody looked through the front window. The traffic was moving smoothly ahead of them. There was no sign of a stoplight. The red car passed the last one between them. It was coming up on their rear bumper now. They passed under a streetlight, and Brody could just make out the shapes of four dog heads in the front and back windows, pressed right against the doors. Oh, man, he said. They're going to jump. Why would they do that? Tuck asked nervously. They're going to catch up to us. No, Brody said. Not jump out. Jump across, into our car. The red car was almost even with them now, right beside them in the other lane. The shadowy dog heads bobbed excitedly. Oh yeah, that makes more sense. We've got to jump. We're going too fast, Patsy warned. You'll burn too much soul. Again, Patsy, no choices, Brody growled. I'm telling you, we're going too fast. They're almost here. We've got to do it. Their shouts competed with the roar of the car engine and the rumble of the road beneath them. The headlights of passing cars and streetlights cast crazy shadows and glares around them. There's no way you can... At that moment, Darkly's big golden body came ripping through the side of their car, his eyes blacker than the night sky and his teeth out and ready. The other hounds were right behind him. There was no more time for argument or for waiting. Brody bared his teeth and jumped out through the other side. He hit the snow-dusted sidewalk hard. His paws had no chance to catch him, and he rolled, pinwheeling and tumbling along the concrete. The world a crazy spinning blur of headlights and dark sky and cold pavement. He came to a rest beside the fence, not hurt, but shaky and senseless. A small whimper slipped out of his throat. Because Brody, he'd felt it. He'd felt the chipping away of his soul with each thump and scrape. He felt it wearing down of his spirit, the light swirling around him. He shook his head. Tuck was sitting a little ways from him, also shaking his head, but already on the rise to his feet. That sucked, buddy, he said. Yeah, Brody said. He looked around. Hey, where's Patsy? Didn't you grab her? Tuck's tail went down. Oops. And that's the end of the chapter. All right, it is Friday, so make sure that you're finishing up your exact path. Make sure you do the check-in question, and then make sure you're reading. And then in Google Classroom today, you're going to go back to Wednesday's assignment, your slideshow, and you're going to complete all of your informational slides. So you should be done through, let's see, slide number, all of your informational slides. So your title slide, your introduction, your first, second, third, fourth, and fifth informational slides. You should be done with slide number 7 by the end of today. Okay, so make sure you're getting all that done. Okay, just like the checklist says, make sure you're writing paragraphs. So this shouldn't be just a bulleted list. Make sure you're writing like 3 to 4 sentences on each slide. Make sure that if you need to change the headings, you've already done that. Okay, and then it also says make sure that you're adding a picture to each slide. So make sure that you're putting your pictures on your slides, just the informational ones, so that way you have can get full points for it. Okay. Hopefully, I will see you all in our Zoom meeting. Please let me know if you have any questions, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye, guys.